Hi. What's up? This is Jyotsna and I'm back with a new video. I probably look a little different right now because I got a haircut. So just casually gonna flaunt the new haircut. So anyway, back to today's video. So there's this habit, a personal habit that I've been wanting to develop for a really, really long time. And this is a habit that I've had before, back in my childhood, which is reading books. Back in school, it was obviously a lot more easier to develop the habit of reading books because you have a library that is screaming and shouting to come and collect books, and you can like borrow a new book each week and just read. So it was so much more encouraging when you have an environment like that to read books. But now that I'm out from college and I literally don't have anything else to do, all that I like doing is scrolling through Instagram reels or watching some YouTube videos or watching Netflix. So yeah, I'm not pretty proud of these habits, which is why I decided that it's time to get back on track and to really read something that I think will be useful, will keep me a lot more productive, and it's a habit that I wanted to develop for a really long time. So it's more like a personal growth challenge for me. So that is why I decided to buy books, and I didn't want to read on my iPad with all the glare and everything. So I decided to buy physical copies of all the books that I thought were the best for me to read. Either they were recommendations from people, or I've read the reviews, I've seen the ratings on Goodreads. I just bought physical copies of all of them. This is not even the entire pile of books that I bought. These are the other books that I bought, but these are fiction, which is why I'm more excited. The only reason I bought so many self-help, personal growth, personal management books is because I know I would never read them if they were on my Kindle or iPad. I find them a lot more boring, and I find some of the books, especially some of the books that I've read which are non-fiction, I feel like one point is repeated like 100 times and it's just blurted out in like 300-400 pages. I don't know if you've ever felt that. If you felt that, comment down below, because I don't want to be the only person. So these are the books that I'm kind of excited about, because let's be real, fictional books, they just put you in another world where you just feel like it's so much more beautiful. You just feel like you're one of those main characters, and yeah, you just go into another world, another universe, you can say. So that's the reason I really like fictional books, and I bought these four. Actually three. One of them is a gift. So this is a gift from one of my best friends. Shout out to Prachitesi Sharma. So she gave me this. I'm being very honest right now, and it's sort of sad and disappointing, but I've never read an Agatha Christie novel before. Like, I've had these in school as well, but for some reason I have always seen myself grabbing a Harry Potter book or a Princess Diaries book, but I never grabbed an Agatha Christie book. So this is actually gonna be the first book that I read by her. Which is surprising yet sad, but at least, you know, I'm at least starting now, so that's the cool part. I've seen some of the movies like Murder on the Orient Express, but I haven't read her books, so this is going to be my first book. Next is this book, which I've heard so many reviews about, and so many people have recommended this book to me, which is The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. I'm very excited to read this. It feels like it's going to be interesting. I didn't read the summary, I didn't read the synopsis, anything, because I just wanted to start off reading without reading anything about the book. So let's see how this goes. Next is one of my favorite writers, Sophie Kinsella. I love her. I've loved the Confessions of Shopaholic series. I've loved Undomestic Goddess. I've Got Your Number. I've Got Your Number is one of my favorite books ever. Can You Keep a Secret? So that's why it's gonna be fun reading this one, because I'm sure I'm gonna like it. But let's see how it goes. Right now my favorite book by her is I've Got Your Number. Let's see if this one is better than that. Another book, again a recommendation and something that I've read a lot about in Goodreads, is Breathless by Jennifer Niven, and it was a very interesting story. I read the summary of this, so that's the reason I bought this. Let's see how it is, and I really love the cover. Look at that, it's so pretty. So these are all the non-fiction books, and gonna pray very hard that it's not gonna be boring and I'm gonna learn something interesting from all of them. So yeah, I'm not gonna explain all of them in detail. As you can see, there are a lot of books, but these are all the books that have been recommended, and these are all the books where wherein, you know, they're either like a million copies sold worldwide, or just a lot of appreciation has been received. So the idea behind this video is to sort of inculcate and get back to my habit of reading books. It's like a personal growth challenge for me, and at the same time, by doing this, I'm sort of like your online virtual. Isn't online and virtual the same thing? I'm gonna be like your virtual reading buddy, so we can like do this together and like read together. I finished 3 books already, so I have just 11 books. Yes. So there are a total of 14 books, just a close review of all the books, out of which I've already finished reading 3, which is Atomic Habits, The Power of Your Subconscious Mind. I kind of want to read this again. It's such a great book. And also The Psychology of Money. So I'm already done with 3 books. Yeah, I'm gonna really try and push myself to do it, but if it's not happening, I'm not gonna force it, because this is a habit that I want it to be enjoyable. I want it to be something fun. I don't want it to feel like work again, you know. That's the whole idea of sort of starting off with this habit in the first place and buying so many books. So let's see how it goes. I'm starting off with You Can Sell by Shiv Khera. The reason why I chose this book is because it's related to sales, and I sort of want to be a sales professional myself. I strive to be a really good sales manager. Like, that's like my future ambition, to be a great sales manager. So I feel like this book can sort of be useful and something great to start off with. As I majored in marketing as well, I think this will be an interesting read, something very close to what I've studied. So I feel like even if it's non-fiction, it might not be that boring, because these are the concepts that I'm genuinely interested in. Let's see how this book goes. Starting off with this.
First of all, start slow. Have a goal of reading just 5 pages in a day, especially if you're a beginner. The number of chapters or the number of pages you read doesn't matter. It's the consistency that matters. So just make sure that you're reading those 5 pages no matter what, and slowly challenge yourself by increasing a few pages later on. Hack number 2, track your reading time. By tracking a habit that you want to develop and timing it as well, just to ensure that you're working on it, helps you stick to it and form it even more easily. I maintain a habit tracker wherein I cross off every time I read on a particular day, and I love maintaining that streak, so it automatically motivates me to read a little bit more. Hack number 3. Choose a book that's enjoyable for you. Like, I started off with a non-fiction book close to what I studied. It would be like a concept brush up for me. Hence, it is so much more enjoyable. So find a book about a topic that you're sure and you'll enjoy, and begin with that book first.
That was it for today's video. I just wanted to film and show you a little bit of reading that I did today. I'm currently on page number 83, which I think is good progress. And yeah, let's see how the journey goes. This is sort of like day one of reading with me. I'm going to be putting up more vlogs like this. So make sure that you subscribe to my channel, and also give this video a thumbs up. It'll encourage me to do more content like this. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Lots of love. Bye. It's gonna fall down.